Okay, so let me see if anything changed after we did this last modification. Actually, there is something that I would like to do here, because looking at this a little bit more, I noticed that there are two attributes, renewed and due date, that we have in loanable item, right? But they don't seem to be really attributes or characteristics of loanable item. They're more characteristics of the association between the loanable item and the patron. Wouldn't you agree?
Well, yeah, it's not like you can only renew a book once in its entire history.
Right, exactly. So that's why what I'd like to do is I would like to move those out of the loanable item. And actually, there is a construct that we can use to express this. It's called, we haven't seen it yet, but it's a special kind of class. It's called an association class. So it's a class that is connected to a specific association. So what we can do here, we can create this class, which I'm going to call checked out. I'm going to associate it with this association. I'm going to connect it with this association. And then I'm going to move the due date and the renewed attributes from the loanable item here in this checked out class. So in this way, it seems to me that it makes it very explicit for somebody looking at this class diagram that these characteristics are characteristics of the loan and not of the elements involved in the loan.
Can you do the same thing with fine? Isn't fine a property of the loan?
Actually it is, right? Because a fine is a fine for a specific loan, right?
That's correct.
Okay, so then we can do that. We don't need to represent fine as a class. We can just transform that into an attribute that we can put into the checked out association class.
Gotcha.
Anything else?
Yeah, it occurred to me that there's another thing that happens. In one of my scenarios, I put down about the patron actually returning an item.
Right. Okay, so we probably need an additional operation, I guess,
right,
for the patron.
Right. Right.
So, okay, so what I'm going to do, that's pretty easy to do. I'm just going to add a return operation here in the patron. And when that happens, that will mean that I'll get rid of this association class because the item is returned. Is that right?
Well, what happens if somebody drops the book in the book drop but doesn't pay if it's overdue and doesn't pay the fine? Will that get rid of the information about what they owe?
Oh, I see. So you can have the item being available, but you still want to know whether there's kind of any pending fines on the book.
And how much those fines are.
And how do you compute how much it is?
It's how many days it was from the time it was due to when they paid to when they returned it.
I see. Okay, so you know what we can do? I think we can put an additional attribute in the checked out class, and I'm going to call it when returned. And that item will have either a special value or it will contain the date in which the book was returned. So in this way, you should be able to kind of keep this in the system until it's paid and also to compute how much the fine is. Was that worth it?
So the special value is for normal situation when they haven't they don't owe anything and haven't returned it yet.
Exactly. So okay. That will tell us that you know that the loan is still active, basically.
Great.
Does that work for you?
Yes.
And you know, I like this. I mean, I feel pretty good about it. I think we have a nice class diagram. So what I would like to do is just go off and clean it up a little bit and put it in an IDE. So that I can pretty print it and rearrange things a little bit. And then I'd like to sit down again and just go through it for a last time and for some final considerations. So if you don't mind, we'll just take a 10-minute break and reconvene here.
That's fine.
All right.